everybody at home. I hope you're all doing fine and well and dandy. We are reaching the T-minus 90 minute mark, and that means that you should have a real good idea of what your pitch is going to look like, and you need to hand it in soon. And it needs to be between 1 minute and 1.5 minutes. And so the company needs this to see whether you succeeded in doing your case and finding a good solution for the problem that was posed. One of these problems, one of these cases, comes from GasUnie, Gas Union. I don't know if you can translate it like that, but GasUnie anyway. My next guest is Wim van Gunderbeek, and he works there, and he has made a case on behalf of the GasUnie, and it's about the energy transition. Is that right, Wim?
Yeah, that's quite right.
Excellent, excellent. I have to ask. It's been. I'm a physicist. I know quite a bit about the energy transition, and it's been quite a tumultuous week with the Shell court case, I would say, right?
Yeah, that is. Yeah, I'm sitting here in a room together with three colleagues. And the first thing we discussed this morning was that case,
yes.
The Shell case. And it's interesting, yes.
And what were your conclusions?
There's a lot of work to do.
yes, because the energy transition means that we need to have a more green, sustainable way of delivering energy everywhere. And this case that you have, what is it about?
The case, yeah, we call it the accelerator platform. And it's about, imagine you have an energy need at a certain location in the country. And how do you fulfill that need? So the question is for energy, so not anymore for gas. Eh? In the earlier days, they asked, give me this and that petajoules of gas. Now it's give me this and that petajoules. And you can fulfill it with gas, with electrons, with hydrogen gas. And the other gas I talked about was aardgas, CH4. And so you can choose who's going to fulfill the need. And to make the choice, you have to do a lot of communication with each other. And there's this case about.
And so what do you directly want to, it's like carte blanche, you just say, okay, we need this many petajoules there, or exajoules, I don't know how many joules, but you need a certain amount of joules and it needs to get there. Good luck.
Yeah, that's one of the possibilities. Another possibility is just imagine you want to place a greenhouse company somewhere, and then you have also to make a choice from what's the right location to do that. So, what types of energy are available at that spot? So that's also a part of the case, a part of the challenge.
So instead of what usually happened is you have some idea of urban planning or some idea where you want to place stuff, and then we just laid down the infrastructure and made it possible. And now you're sort of turning it around with thinking, okay, maybe we should adjust the planning to the energy possibilities or where there's a superfluous amount of energy, for instance?
That is a possibility, but it's not turning it around. But it's not the only question from I need some energy over there. Now there are other types of questions. I'm looking for a suited place to put my greenhouse or to put my aluminium factory. Yeah, my colleague here says it's about combining infrastructures.
And how is the case team doing so far, or how are your case teams doing? I don't know how many teams you are currently thinking about this problem.
At this moment, we have three teams thinking. And early this morning, it was a little hard startup to find everybody. But after 1 hour, we discovered that everybody understands our case, and they ask the right questions. So we were very enthusiastic about what students ask, and we hope for a very good solution.
How do you see the future of for instance, a company like the GasUnie? What's the idea within the company where it might go? Is that also very open and very wide, or it must be something very interesting what you're thinking about?
Yeah, it's very open, it's wide, there are a lot of possibilities, but I think we have to stay at the basis of our company. We are a transporting company, we're a logistic company. So the only thing we have is pipes, and we transport energy in the form of molecules. So as long as the energy transition results in another molecule, we can transport it.
Whether it be methane or hydrogen, that really doesn't matter. The infrastructure remains roughly the same.
Yeah. Yes, okay. Indeed.
And so you've been thinking about this problem for, I think, a couple of decades, probably. What do you hope that will come out of it differently? Do you think the students might come with a completely new idea?
Yeah, I hope so. This is an IT related problem. The people, my colleagues from the IT department are thinking, I think they started 7 years ago with thinking about it. Ah. And they look at it from an IT point of view. And the big advantage of this challenge is that we have students from all kinds of directions and with all kinds of knowledge. So maybe there's a solution from quite another view.
And is this an idea of that you want to use students later on more often? I mean, this is something that you might do in the future as well.
Oh yes, for sure. This the energy transition needs a lot of innovation, and for innovation, I dare not say it, but you also need younger people. Yeah, they have the wildest idea. Yeah, I'm old. I've also wild ideas, but I think it can be more wild.
Yeah, just new realms because I'm compared to these students, I'm already old as well. But some things that we haven't thought of possible, maybe.
I hope for that.
They are living in the world of tomorrow. I mean, the world that needs the energy transition. I mean, that is something. Do you sense more acuteness of the problem with the younger generation, maybe? That they are more used to the idea that climate change is real and one of the biggest problems that might come along? The urgency?
I wouldn't use the word acuteness. I think they are raised together with this challenge, and for them it's common. It's everyday business. I raised 50 years ago, and I was used in the classic way thinking, and. Energy, how do you say it? The use of new forms of energy wasn't my kind of thinking for until 2 years ago. So if you proposed to me an electric car 2 years ago, I would say, oh, no way, nothing for me. Now I'm hesitating, so I'm not convinced yet.
It's turning around. I'll take you on a test drive in my electric car when
okay,
this is all
yeah,
over.
Okay, yeah, that's good. Yeah.
And then the fun thing is it goes faster in the acceleration because of the linear torque. It goes faster than pretty much any gasoline car that I meet at the stoplight. So that's amazing. It's a lot of fun.
I like the sounds of And the smell of oil. Yeah.
Oh, I love the smell of gasoline. It's just, it's heating up yeah. the planet. That's the only downside. Otherwise, I love this stuff. I mean, 36 megajoules per liter. It's amazing. I love it, but yeah. it has some downsides. Anyway, yes. I thank you so much, Wim, for this conversation. And I hope that your teams, your three teams, find amazing new breakthroughs and that we can tackle this problem together. That would be wonderful.
Okay, yeah, I hope so.
Thank you so much.
Thanks for the interview. Nice.
Thank you.
Okay. Hey, bye-bye.
Bye-bye, Wim. So, everybody at home, it's now 3:40, so that means that you have 80 minutes left. So I would say chop chop, get to work, and don't forget to hand in your pitch. Good luck.